students, welcome to HV Kapadia School. I am Nisha James and I am taking biology practical. Today we are going to do the third biology 11th standard practical, that is the TES of gonocotyledon. So as you know that TS means transverse section, okay, and it is normally circular in outline. Now when you take TS of gonocotyledon, you will get the following anatomy. Now I am going to tell you what about the anatomy of TS of monocot root. The monocot root, the outermost layer of the monocot root, it is called epidermis. You can find, okay, so this is the TS of monocot root, the outermost layer that I have given in red color, sorry, yellow color. So, the outermost layer is epidermis. Okay, in this diagram I have represented epidermis with yellow color. Epidermis consists of single layer of parenchymatous cell. From the epidermis you can find some outgrowth. So this outgrowth is called root hair, responsible for absorption of water from the soil. And below the epidermis you can find a multicellular cortex. Cortex consists of parenchymatous cells and they are arranged loosely. As they are arranged loosely, it consists of loads of intercellular space. Look at the diagram. This blue colored form structure is the cortex. You can find that in between the cell there are loads of space. Okay, so that is intercellular space. What is the meaning of intercellular space? Inter means in between. The space between two cells, that is called intercellular space. So cortex consists of loosely arranged parenchymatous cells with intercellular space. Now after the cortex, the next layer, that is called endodermis. You can find the endodermis I have represented in a purple color. So the purple color structure is called endodermis. This endodermis is normally made up of barrel shaped parenchymatous cells. But in certain cells, you can find there is a thick deposition of Casparian strip that will prevent the absorption of water and also it protects the vascular tissue from any poisonous material. Now below the endodermis, you can find a layer that is called pericycle. Pericycle I have represented in the yellow color. You can find this yellow color structure that is called pericycle. Okay, now this pericycle, which will allow the passage of substances from cortex to the pith region. Okay, now then you can find below this pericycle, you can find the vascular tissue system. The vascular tissue system consists of both xylem and phloem. You can find the pink color circular structure, that is the xylem. Okay, normally in monocot root you can find many number of xylem bundles. The xylem consists of both protoxylem and also metaxylem. Protoxylem is normally small in size. Look at here, you can find the small xylem, that's my xylem is protoxylem, and the bigger one, you can find the bigger one, that is called metaxylem. Okay, so here you can find that the protoxylem is arranged towards the periphery. As it is arranged towards the periphery, such an arrangement is called exarch arrangement. Okay, so normally in root you can find exarch arrangement of xylem. So what is the meaning of exarch? As the protoxylem is arranged towards the periphery, it is called exarch arrangement. Protoxylem is small in size and metaxylem is big in size. Then you can find phloem. Phloem is located in between the xylem vascular bundle. Look at this, this green color portion is the phloem. Phloem consists of small parenchymatous cell. And so that about the vascular bundle. Vascular bundle consists of alternate xylem and phloem. Such an arrangement is called radial vascular bundle. Normally, there are some technical terms to represent the vascular bundle. In a root, the technical terms are, the vascular bundles are mainly exarch and also radial. What is the meaning of radial? The vascular bundle, the xylem and phloem, they are arranged in different radii. That's why it is called radial vascular bundle. And as they are alternate with each other, this is called alternate vascular bundle. And towards the same responsibility and it consists of number of parent gametes cell. So this is about the anatomy of monocotyledon.
So students, so we have completed the anatomy of monocotyledon. Now I am going to tell you how to take the TS of monocotyledon. So this is a monocotyledon. You can find that on the surface of this monocotyledon you can find fine hairs. So these are the root hairs. I told you that the root hairs are arising from the epidermis. And what is the function of the root hair? Root hair is normally responsible for absorption of water from the soil. Now I will tell you how to take the TS. First you have to take the blade. I told you that every time you have to take a new blade, then only you will get a thin section. You have to dip the blade in water. Now we have to do the section. I told you that how to take the section. First you have to cut this continuously, nearly 5 to 6 sections you have to take. Okay, after taking this 5 to 6 section, okay, you have to transfer this section into a petri dish. Okay, so now I am transferring the sections in petri dish. So this is the petri dish. Petri dish contains some amount of water, because in the absence of water the section will get dry. Now what we have to do is we have to select one of the thin section. Okay, so I am selecting one of my thin section. Now we have to transfer this thin section. How to take the thin section? With help of brush only. Okay, so this is the brush. With the help of the brush I have taken the thin section. Now I am transferring this thin section in a watch glass containing steel. Okay, so I have transferred my section into the watch glass. In the watch glass I have added the stain. Which stain? It is safranin. Okay, so the safranin is a concentrated stain. So normally what you have to do is, you have to add, after adding one drop of stain, you have to add one or two drops of water. Then it becomes diluted. Okay, so I have transferred my section. Now what you have to do is, you have to wait for 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, you have to transfer the section in a slide. Okay, so now we have to transfer the section. Now I am transferring my section. I told you that every time we have to keep the section in the middle of the slide. Okay, so when you are doing transferring, some amount of stain will also come. So this extra stain you have to remove with help of a blotting paper. So I am removing the extra stain with help of a blotting paper. Now we have to add one drop of water. And after adding one drop of water, okay, we have to take a cover slip. You have to dip the cover slip in water. And then you have to hold the cover slip in an angle of 45 degree. And gently you have to put the cover slip. I told you that when you are putting cover slip, you have to take care that there should not be any air bubble. Now I am going to keep this slide inside the microscope.
So students, I have kept the slide under the microscope. Now I am going to tell you, I will show you what about the anatomy of this monocotyledon. Okay, so I am going to focus the camera on the microscope.
So students, you can find the anatomy of monocotyledon. On the outermost layer you can find the root hairs. Okay, this is the anatomy of monocotyledon. You can find the root hair, epidermis, then the multicellular cortex with intercellular space, and also the circular cavity below the endodermis. You can find an endodermis. And below the endodermis you can find the vascular bundle. The circular cavity you can find, that is the xylem. Okay, so that about the TS of the monocotyledon. Thank you.